Invest has published a new report on the Spanish insurance market using best credit rating methodology, BCRM, as a basis for analysis. BCRM is for insurance companies, but how did the Spanish market fare under this analysis? I'm Yvette Essen for AM Best TV, and I'm joined by Carlos Wong-Fupuy, Senior Director. We've started to do this report based on analysis of the companies using the building blocks approach, using a fictitious company, Spain Insurance SA. Can you tell me, using this methodology, this approach, were there any limitations? And what was the basis exactly of your analysis?
The latest version of our methodology, our BCRM, was published in October 2017. This time we decided to apply this to a fictitious company, Spain Insurance SA, based on the statistics of the whole insurance sector in Spain. So, first of all, one of the caveats is that the BCRM is designed for insurance company ratings only. So, when we interpret the results, we shouldn't think that it's related to a sovereign debt ratings. Say, AM Best doesn't issue sovereign debt ratings. It's not a rating on the market itself because we are not capturing differences between companies. It's not an average rating, or it's not an indicative rating on any company in particular. But we think that it's an interesting exercise because, on the one hand, it illustrates a practical application of the methodology, and at the same time allows us to give our opinion about the insurance market in general in Spain using the BCRM as a framework.
So using the building blocks framework, can you summarize some of the weaknesses and the strengths found within your analysis?
Yes, if we follow the building blocks one by one, let's start with balance sheet strength. So the capital position of the Spanish insurance sector is very healthy. It's a very well-diversified market. There are some concerns, obviously, about concentration on Spanish sovereign debt, but there is a logic behind that, since they are being used to support long-term life business, and we consider that the risks by regulators and by main companies is very well closely monitored. Apart from that, the quality of the assets is very good. Say, goodwill is almost negligible, very low financial leverage. And on top of that, we have the role of El Consorcio, the catastrophe scheme supported by the government, which allows the market to stabilize results and show resilience over the years.
Thanks for explaining the balance sheet strength element. Can you tell me a little bit about the other building blocks as well?
The second one, operating performance, for example, say we have Spain is one of the markets within the European Union with the healthiest technical margins. Not just that, but it's very resilient on the non-life side. On the life side, the picture is a bit more mixed because volumes tend to be a bit more volatile. And this is because historically, the Spanish life insurance sector has shown sensitivity to movements in interest rates and new product offerings. But in general, we think that despite the market being still under significant pressure, it's got much more room of maneuver compared to other European markets. Business profile, the Spanish insurance market is mature, it's developed, it's well diversified by product lines and by distribution channels. One exception is probably just life insurance business, where is very heavy concentration on bank assurance and dependence on bank assurance. But when we look at the market as a whole compared to other ones, in terms of all the rankings within the EU and globally, I would say it's more like a strong middle of the table player. So I think that the picture there is a bit mixed. ERM is an area where it's probably the most challenging for us to assess on an aggregated basis because of the differences that we have within companies. So there is a broad range of individual characteristics when companies apply ERM. Definitely there has been a positive role from Solvency II application, but it has been certainly limited in particular cases. In general, for example, application of internal capital models or stress testing could be more sophisticated when we compare Spain to other markets. But at the same time, one of the things that we have to recognize is that the market tends to be lower in terms of risk profile compared to other markets. So we could say that the ERM frameworks tend to be in line with that risk profile.
Overall, can you draw any particular conclusions as a result of this analysis?
Yes, when we apply the BCRM approach and look at the different assignments of the rating scale, say we started with the balance sheet strength and we saw that that balance sheet strength could start possibly within a range of BBB plus to A, that would be the baseline assessment. We look at operating performance, and that could lead to an adjustment upwards of one notch. The same happens with business profile, another notch positive, and ERM possibly between zero and minus one notch. So we end up with a range of outcomes which could be between the BBB and AA minus on an ICR issuer credit rating scale. So obviously, as I mentioned before, we shouldn't take this as an indicator of ratings on any particular companies. Say in the report, we quote the individual results if somebody wants to get into more detail.
A copy of that report on AM Best Spanish Market using the BCRM methodology as a basis can be found on the website ambest.com. For AM Best TV, I'm Yvette Essen.